Well, hello everyone, and welcome to Thief Gold. This is a game that was requested from Rewarding the Rewarders. I don't know this game very well. I'm not going to be a very good player at it. I'm mostly going to be just derping around and getting myself killed. I did spend about 3 or 4 hours 6 months ago playing this game and trying to get a feel for it. It is pretty damn fun, but it is incredibly hard, primarily, in my opinion, because of the keys. These are the keybinds. There's a lot of them. There's a lot to learn. It's almost like a space sim with the amount of damn controls you have to learn. I don't know. If you're good at this game, I don't suggest watching this because it's going to be absolutely horrible. We'll just start a new game here. I'm going to keep it on normal difficulty. I'm pretty sure harder difficulties just give you more objectives to complete. And I guess we might as well go through training. This first video will just be the training tutorial crap. I need a refresher anyways. The essence of balance is detachment. To embrace a cause, to grow fond or spiteful, is to lose one's balance. After which, no action can be trusted. Our burden is not for the dependent of spirit. From Maiar, the Third Keeper.
I was a kid. No parents, no home. Running messages and picking pockets to keep my ribs from meeting my spine. One night I saw a man. Folks just passed him by like he wasn't there. I thought he must have something valuable, so I snuck up on him and made a grab.
That's not for you.
Please, sir, I'm hungry. Don't tell the hammers, I promise.
What is your name, boy?
Garrett.
You have talent, lad.
Let go of me, old man!
To see a keeper is not an easy thing, especially one who does not wish to be seen. We have a need for those as gifted as yourself. If you've grown tired of how you live, then follow me, and we will show you a different way.
Leave me alone!
As you wish.
I caught up with him just before he vanished into the crowd. It was the beginning of a very long education.
So, a keeper's training, difficulty normal, follow the directions of your instructor in order to pass the training tests. Pretty straightforward, right? Obviously, in the full game, the missions get much more complex.
In the nearby rooms, I will instruct you in the various skills you will need to survive. Please stay in the entrance area to each room while I explain the room's purpose. When you are ready to begin your lessons, proceed down this hallway to the first room.
Okay. So he's going to be overwatching us through most of this, I guess. I don't know my keys. Shift makes me walk. F is my crouch key.
You must learn how to move unseen. Stay in the shadows. Avoid the light. The indicator on your screen will tell you how visible you are. Try to reach the top of the platform without being seen.
Okay. So, I'm just going to crouch here. I'm not going to walk. I want to see if he's going to be able to hear me from that far away. I bet you he will hear me if I don't walk. No? Even right under his nose he didn't hear my footsteps. Not a very observant guard.
Well done. Okay. I did not see you approach.
Open this door to continue. When the door is near the center of your screen, it will light up, indicating that it is selected. To manipulate selected doors and other objects, use them.
Okay, so right click.
Good. Proceed down this corridor for your next test.
And this is my tiptoe speed. W is my regular walk speed. S is my tiptoe speed. X is my walk backwards key.
Now you must learn to move quietly. Some surfaces are louder than others when walked upon. And moving quickly makes more noise than moving slowly. Listen to your own footsteps to hear how much noise you are making. The instructor will have his back turned. You must get to the top of the platform without being heard.
Okay. So this that I'm on seems pretty quiet. I'm gonna guess that metal here. Yeah, not that quiet at all. So that stuff we kind of need to avoid if possible. And then I will use my super slow tiptoe speed in order to sneak behind this guy and slice his throat. Probably not. We're all brothers here.
Very good. I did not hear you traverse the room.
Beyond this door is a hallway that will lead you to your next task.
If we would have went that way, we probably would have failed due to that metal there. We can hear them from all the way across the room if they touch that metal. It's good to know. Sound plays a very important role in this game.
Now get your weapons. To pick up objects, select them by centering them on screen until they light up. Then use them. Choose your weapon now. Try readying your sword and then your bow. You can always put them away again if you need your hands free. Now let's go out to the courtyard for some target practice.
And I have 30 arrows. I wonder what happens if you run out of arrows.
Knock an arrow and draw back the string by holding down the attack button. Make sure you draw all the way back, or your shot will not have full power. Okay. Take aim, and when you are ready to shoot, release your attack. See if you can hit one of these targets.
I'm sure I can.
Good shot.
Hell, almost bullseye.
If you wish. When you are ready to proceed, approach the training dummy and ready your sword.
Hang on. So at this distance, probably there. Yeah, close.
Swing at the target with your attack button. A quick tap will give you a slash. Move the tip of your sword to the left of the target for a left slash, and to the right of the target for a right slash. Pull the attack button down, then release for an overhead swing. Try both slashes and the overhead swing on the practice dummy.
Oh, I can't. The dummy is gone.
Enter the cobbled sparring area.
Okay. So block is my middle mouse button. I wasn't actually expecting you to charge me, you jerk.
Fall over!
Like that? I can't tell exactly when he's hitting me and when he's not.
Fall over!
Keep sparring, Josh. When you are done, leave the sparring area.
I guess I'm expecting blood to spray everywhere. I think I'm done sparring with you.
Please walk over to the table.
Yeah, I'm done. This table, I guess?
Would you care for some refreshment before we move on, young Garrett?
I don't know if I'd trust this food.
Cycle through your inventory to see the objects you have in your pockets. Once an object is displayed, you may use it. Have something to eat if you wish. Then you may proceed. The next test is waiting on the other side of the metal door.
Okay.
The door is locked, but the key from the table will open it. To unlock the door, select the key in your inventory. Center the door on screen until it lights up. Then use the key on the door. Good. Now head down this hallway to get to your next test.
I'm surprised the key didn't break or vanish. I guess I've been traumatized with having to hunt down dozens of keys in the past.
Now you will learn new movement skills. First, climb the rope by jumping onto it.
Okay.
Move while looking up or down to climb up or down the rope. Turn to change your facing. If you jump again, you will release the rope. Now climb the rope to get to the top of the platform.
You have to be pretty damn accurate.
Well done. Run and jump across the gap to the other side of the stream.
I'm not sure what my run key is. Maybe it's just my regular watch key.
This obstacle is easy to climb if you know how. First, move close to the wall. Next, jump
one step ahead of you, buddy.
And pull yourself up. Good job. I'm most pleased with your progress. You have passed the last test for today. If you wish, you may stay to practice your climbing and jumping, or swimming, ducking, leaning, or crawling. When you are finished, you may return to your chambers by going through that red door.
Okay. Farewell.
The keepers were training me to be one of them. But I found other uses for those skills.
Interesting. Damn it, I wanted to steal that plant. I really had high hopes that I was going to be able to take that with me. Okay, so we passed that. Stats took 7 minutes. Another cutscene. I don't know how much story this game actually has, but I can assure you we're not going to see most of it. I think Grimmeth has a full Let's Play that I'll link in the description of this video. The Golden Key. The most promising acolyte left us, not out of the lesser folly of sentiment, but the greater folly of anger. His heart was clouded, and his balance was lost, but his abilities were unmatched. Even then, we knew to watch him most carefully. From the Keeper Annals. Probably talking about me, I guess. I don't know.
I have a simple job planned for this evening. Break into a guarded mansion, steal another fat nobleman's priceless trinket, and leave quietly. Lord Baffert is out of town, and rumor has it that the captain of his house guard went with him as a bodyguard. The time is ripe for a bit of burglary. The front gate of Lord Baffert's manor is always guarded, and the main street is far too exposed. But Cuddy tells me there's a better way in. Around to the side, more out of the way. One guard, and likely no witnesses to complicate matters. The piece Cuddy wants is a scepter. Silver, jewels, the usual adornments. It should command a high price. Baffert, like most of his kind, probably keeps his treasures on the top floor of the place, close to his heart, and far from his servants. No point in waiting. I have Cuddy's old sketches of the place, and everyone who's going to be asleep inside already is. It's time to begin.
Time to get our burger on. So, Lord Baffert's Manor. Difficulty normal, of course. We have to sneak into Lord Baffert's Manor and case the place. The well house in back is our best bet, if we can get the key from the guard. Blackjacking or pickpocketing him would be quietest. Then we need to find the jeweled scepter and redistribute it to ourselves. Try to do it without causing too much commotion. Okay. Let's see. Difficulty hard. That says in addition to pinching the scepter, steal 350 worth of valuables while we're in there. Don't kill any of the servants. They're harmless. And once we've achieved our other objectives, get out of the manor house and back to the city streets. You know what? Kill anyone, still 700. I think we'll just do hard. This is kind of like GoldenEye, where the objectives can... They're a little bit more difficult, but it's also more fun. It gives you more to aim for. Let's continue here. I'll probably end the video before I actually start the mission. These are the items that we start with. A sword, blackjack, water arrows, 8 of them, a healing potion, and 36 broadhead arrows. I have 350 in cash. But I don't really need anything else. I mean, there's no way I should be using 36 broadhead arrows. So, let's just play the mission. And this is where we start, out here on the streets. I'm going to go ahead and save the game and end the video here. This has been kind of an audio test, and whenever we return, we will start our first actual mission. Let's see how quickly I can get myself killed.